colleges and universities are currently struggling to keep the H1N1 virus off campus.
Simpson College is one of them. News Channel 8's Carrie Gavin shows us how they're also trying to fight off another serious health problem. Carrie.
Stacey, 5 student athletes at Simpson College have confirmed cases of the staph infection MRSA. While athletic department cares for those athletes, they're also trying to make sure other athletes, staff, or students don't get it as well.
Student athletes at Simpson College work hard in practice to prevent themselves from injury when it's game time. So when a football player developed a staph infection earlier this month, many student athletes became concerned about their health.
But I think they know, they realize that skin infections isn't just isolated to wrestling. It is something that can be associated with other teams.
After the first staph infection was confirmed, 4 other infections quickly followed.
All of the cases that we have are within the football program.
Since the infection is transferred through open wounds, the athletic department knew that contact sport athletes would be more susceptible to the infection.
All the locker rooms, weight rooms, all of the different facilities have been fogged.
Coaches, athletes, and trainers have stepped up their personal hygiene while also disinfecting common use areas and equipment more often.
We have a 2-page checklist of how to deal with the issue.
We've worked together, worked with all the teams, let them know what the signs and symptoms are.
While the infections are isolated in the athletic department, the entire Simpson community uses the athletic facilities.
I have a couple of friends that like to go work out, and they're really afraid to use the weight room because they don't want to catch staph infection.
My roommate is a football player, so I mean, it's kind of something that wouldn't scare me as well, because I live with them, we use the same shower and everything, the same sink and all that stuff every day, so it's definitely a big concern.
The 5 football players who have MRSA are not participating in practice or games, but the athletic director says they're all doing well in attending classes. They should be back on the field within the next few weeks.
And Carrie, do they know how the spread of staph happened?
Well, as of right now, they do not. The football team shares a locker room with another men's team, and none of those players have any symptoms. Also, there was some concern that the turf on the field could contain some bacteria causing staph, but other players who play on the field have had no problems as well. So it's something they're still trying to figure out.
Okay. Carrie Gavin, live in the newsroom tonight. Thank you, Carrie.